Hey guys, it's Danny. Today, a very, very exciting video. I'm starting my very first terrarium, which of course will contain mostly orchids. So I'm gonna take you along as I'm building it, walk you through the thought process. I'm gonna show you the orchids that I'm gonna use. Some of them you really don't know. I got them specifically for this project. There will of course be some design elements to it, and I hope that in the end, it will look interesting and the orchids will do great. So don't forget to like this video if you enjoy it. It really helps my videos out. And why not subscribe? I post 3 times a week. So with that said, let me tell you a little bit about this aquarium. Okay, so some of you might actually recognize this aquarium. It used to be Charlie's old home. It is a Fluval aquarium, about 30 liters. It looks more like a cube, and I personally never liked it for my betta. The problem with it is that it's rather narrow and tall. And you know what? For a terrarium, this is not a bad thing. The rounded edges, I have to say, I really like. It's very, very stylish. And I also like the fact that this aquarium came with a background. It is a foam background, and with terrariums, usually people design their own background. They make a moss wall, which, to be quite honest, I don't want to do because moss degrades. It's just another thing to maintain. And at least for now, being that this is my first terrarium, I don't want to have a moss wall. The lamp is actually an aquarium lamp. It didn't come with this particular aquarium. My other tank is from Denerli, and this is the lamp that came together with that kit, which is very, very dim for the size of that aquarium. But I do believe it will do great for this terrarium, but I'm not entirely sure if it's full spectrum. I'll have to investigate a little bit. Now, the soil that I will be using is quite an interesting mixture, fairly new for me, but I think it will do great in the setting of a terrarium. It is a mixture between cocoa peat, bark chips, and perlite. As far as ratios go, I think I used about 60 or 70% cocoa peat and the rest in equal amounts bark and perlite. The aim was to create something which is water retentive, but also well draining and pretty airy at the same time. I will be using both terrestrial orchids or semi-terrestrials and also epiphytic orchids. And while some orchids will of course be mounted, some will be planted, and I want this mixture to be suited for those types of plants as well. Luckily, these plants do enjoy their moisture, so this medium I think will do great both for terrestrial orchids and epiphytic orchids, which like high moisture. To this medium, I will also add activated carbon that I found at the pet shop. Again, it's something that I've never used, but in the setting of this terrarium, which does not have any drainage, I believe it might help. I'll mix the charcoal though when I add the medium because I'm not gonna use everything. So I have here some pieces of wood and rocks. I found all of these at the pet shop. Whether I'm gonna use all of them or how I'm gonna use them exactly, I don't know. We're gonna see where my artistic endeavor leads me. Definitely, I would like to mount some orchids on this wood, but I do believe the rock will give some depth to the design as well. Alrighty then, so with that said, I think it's time to add the medium. So first of all, I'm just going to add some soil and then try to shape it as I go. The aim is to make a lower level in the front and a higher level in the back. This will give depth, pretty much like aquascaping, right? Or at least this is what I think. Let's see how this goes. So I'm pretty sure I'm gonna add more soil, but what I wanna do now is actually add that layer of activated charcoal. I think it's enough for me to start to play around with the hardscape, which is always the fun part, but also the most difficult part for me. So I played a little bit with some layouts outside of the terrarium, and I've reached to this shape, which I kinda like, but because I actually don't have very tall pieces of wood, I will have to add a little bit more soil into the aquarium before I place the pieces. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that really fast. Okay, so here we reached quite a nice display. Will this remain like this? I don't know, because I do intend to put some foreground plants, which are not orchids. You'll see what I mean. And orchids, I want them in between these rocks and also mounted to the wood. I really, really wished I had a taller piece of wood. I might actually at some point go to the pet shop and try to find some of those really twirly branches to add to this aquarium. I think they will spice up a little bit the design, but this is what I have for now. So I'm gonna do the best I can with what I have for now, and I might add things later. At least for an aquascape, this would look nice. Right, so let's introduce the orchids now. First off, here we have the Restrepia elegans. This has a beautiful flower. I have to say, I'm not personally a huge fan of Restrepias, although in terrariums I do think they look great. This one has a beautiful, beautiful flower. It is a new orchid, it arrived to me with a little bud. I don't know if it may transport, but it's okay. This one is a warm grower. It enjoys high humidity. It comes from high humidity environments, and it appears to be an orchid commonly used in terrariums. This one is actually a related orchid. This is a Pleurothallis tribuloides. Hopefully I'm pronouncing these correctly. Again, it is a warm grower that natively grows in very, very humid environments. I purposely chose rather warm or at least intermediate growers, not cool growers, because my terrarium will not be cool. It will be room temperature, but it will be humid. So I did try as much as possible to pick things that do not require very cool conditions. Next up, a little orchid which I will not pronounce right now. I need to investigate a little bit how to pronounce this, but it is a miniature orchid, again, very, very suited for terrariums. This one produces really, really cute pink flowers, and you can see that I already have some new roots growing. She's looking so, so precious. This one will definitely be mounted on the wood pieces. Another orchid that I intend to mount on one of the wood pieces is the Arrangis kirkii, or kirkii. If you're a native English speaker, this is how you would pronounce it. So as we can see, I have two plants here. They're actually not connected. So I decided to grow one in this pot and one will go in the terrarium because this orchid is a miniature and can actually be grown in terrariums. It also produces really, really lovely flowers. Next, why not use the cucumber orchid as well? I think I will take a cutting from this. If you remember, we actually divided it a while back and the divisions took. There we go. So I can actually divide it once again. It grows really, really fast. And I think it will look absolutely fantastic in the terrarium. It is a tiny orchid, even if it grows fast. I'm wondering if I can make it grow on one of the pieces of wood. I may or may not use a piece from my Laodicea discolor. I was thinking about this one since it doesn't really have too many roots. The problem is this is a pretty big orchid and I'm not sure how it's going to look in the terrarium because all of the orchids that I have are pretty tiny and this one will look like a giant compared to the other ones. So I don't know, might use it, I might not. I'm also seriously considering to add the Paphiopetalum delenati because it's a tiny paff and it just looks darling. I'm not yet decided though, we'll see about it. Just for the fun of it, I do believe I'm going to add one of these keikis on my Dendrobium lodigesi. This type of Dendrobium has a climbing nature, although everybody's trying to grow it pendant. So if it likes the environment, I think it will look great. Although this is more of a cooler growing orchid, I however didn't have any type of issues growing it in my greenhouse, which is mostly warm to intermediate. So that said, let's just get to planting. Alright, so I will speed things up, but you will see there is a lot of trial and error in arranging these orchids. I changed my mind multiple times, I relocated them, I tried different locations for certain orchids, and that's all okay. You can actually have an image in your mind, but when you actually do it, it doesn't really look like it's supposed to. So yeah, I moved things a lot until I reached to a design that looked good for me. I also lucked out with the Paphiopetalum because that little tiny growth was not actually a new growth, it was a totally separate plant. So I'm thinking that little path is a seedling. Alright, so everything looks pretty great. I feel the need for something right here. However, I do actually plan to have a foreground plant as well, which is not an orchid. So I was thinking to add a Sophronitis to the mix, but to be fully honest, I'm not sure if it will work out with everything that I already have here, which, to be fully honest, has beautiful blooms, but it's mainly focused on foliage. This one doesn't look like a great foliage plant, so I will hold on to it. I might actually try to find or order another type of orchid to put right here. For now, I know there's a big gap there, but honestly, I don't want to put anything just yet. So these are the orchids, which will be in this terrarium for now. Some of them might not remain here. I'm not sure about the Lodicea. My idea is that it will kind of lean forward. It will creep along the medium, but if it doesn't want to do that and it becomes a nuisance and a monster in this aquarium, then I'm gonna pull it out. So now let's go ahead and tie everything up with the foreground plant, which I'm sure will surprise you. And the surprise plant that will make the foreground is... ta-da! It's a typical clover plant. I actually got this from one of the pots in which my orchids came in. I potted it separately, I multiplied it because I really like clover and I thought it would look great as foreground in a terrarium, right? So I will try to divide it into a few clumps. As you will see, it produces runners, it can become invasive, there will be some maintenance involved so it doesn't take over everything. But I think it looks gorgeous. So I'll do that really fast and come back with the planting process. We are almost done. At this point, some people take a brush and start to remove all of the soil that is in between the crevices. I personally don't like to do that. I like the whole natural effect. Of course, there are some places where, yeah, maybe a little maintenance wouldn't hurt, but something like this, I wanted to have a little bit of soil there because that will hold on to moisture. And if I so desire to put moss at some point, if I come across more moss, live moss that is, I will put it there and it will have moisture rather than a bare rock. And it just looks a little bit more natural. It looks like nature intended that to be there, kind of. Although, this is definitely not natural. All of these plants are not found together in the same place in nature. A biotope is definitely not what I'm trying to do here. But as much as possible, I do want it to look fairly natural. I don't want to have pots in this aquarium or other things that scream humanity, if it makes sense. All right, so before we water it well, we need to make it bioactive. And this means adding springtails that I cultured myself. Links down below in the description if you're interested to see how I did that. Alrighty, so I added the springtails. I was not shy. I added as many as I could while still maintaining my colonies active. I used a wash bottle to just rinse the pieces of charcoal that contained the springtails. And actually, I will continue with the wash bottle and wet all of the medium. I will try to be cautious with the crowns of the Paphiopetalum, maybe even the Arrangis, and of course the Lodicea, because this will not be a very ventilated setup. And since it's brand new, we don't have bacteria to help us out. The springtails will help us with mold spores and molds altogether, but I don't have a lot of them. The balance is not set yet. I think it's pretty much like cycling an aquarium, so I don't want to take any risks with that. I will just water at the base of the orchid as much as possible. Okay, so I actually brought it in the house. This is where I'm gonna keep it, not in the greenhouse. I want to enjoy it when I'm not in the greenhouse as well. Now, it looks a little empty, I know, but as I go, I will add stuff. I wanna add some more branches, some more orchids, which of course will need ordering, but I do really, really like it. And for a person who is not very talented at crafting, I actually don't think it looks half bad. I'm pretty happy with myself. Now, fingers crossed that it's going to be okay. I'm expecting molds, I'm expecting all sorts of stuff that typically happen with a fresh terrarium. I'm thinking so much of aquariums right now and the startup of an aquarium. I don't know if it's the same thing. So I'm just preparing for the worst for a few weeks. But I'm hoping that the biostimulants that I added will do their job and bacteria will accumulate in time and it will maintain the balance. And yeah, stay tuned. I will keep you up to date. Hopefully everything will work out okay. And actually, after a few days, I did start to have a little bit of mold on the wood, which is absolutely normal. But can we see that the springtails are already on top of the situation, literally? And I have to say, a week since I made this terrarium, all of that mold is almost gone. It's considerably less. So that's good. It means the terrarium is stabilizing. So, alrighty guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this. Stay tuned for updates. I will be sure to keep you in the loop. Subscribe to my channel for more orchid videos, tutorials, experiments, updates, and other fun orchid subjects. If you wish to support the channel, do consider becoming a member or visit the merch store linked down below in the description. You can also follow me on Instagram and Facebook. It's always nice to stay in touch there as well. And with that said, I'll see you next time. Bye!